Hello world, and welcome to Coding After Facts Back to Basics. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about comments and statements and what they are and how to use them. I'm going to start this off by first going over what is a statement. A statement is a command that tells the computer, or in our case a program, what we want it to do. And I'm going to use one of the most common statements that people see, which is var, which creates a variable. So in my print layer over here, I'm going to go into source text. And I'm going to type in var, and I'm going to give it a name of list, and I'm going to have it equal to an array of 0. And I'm going to put a semicolon at the end. And in the last line, I'm going to return list. And of course, since we only had 0 in this array, it's just going to return 0 over here. And I know you've seen examples where you don't see a semicolon at the end and the program still works. And the reason for this is because expression has a mechanic in there called auto semicolon insertion. And what it basically does is if it sees a statement and it doesn't have a semicolon, in the background, a semicolon is added to that statement. So if I was to get rid of this semicolon and push enter, you can see my code didn't break and nothing happened. But there are cases where a semicolon is needed, and if you don't put it in there, it's going to return you an error. So I'm going to show you one of those situations where this might happen. So I'm going to create another variable, and I'm going to name it num, and I'm going to have it equal to 1. And I'm going to add one more number to our list array, and I'm going to type in list push. And in parentheses, I'm going to add in 1. And what push does is it adds whatever we have in parentheses into our array. In the next line, I'm going to type in plus plus num. And what this basically do is it adds 1 to whatever we have for that num variable, which is 1. So it should come out 2. But since I'm pushing 1, up here, it should say 01 once I push enter. But once I push enter, you see that we get an error. And you might think to yourself, the reason why we have an error, especially with me going on and talking about semicolons, is because there is no semicolon anywhere every time I make a new statement. And that is not the case. The reason why we get an error is because of these two lines right here. And After Effects is looking at this and looking at the plus that we have right here, and it's thinking to itself that since the plus is the first thing that on this line, that it has to be connected with this statement here, which is not the case. So if I add a semicolon right here telling After Effects that this is where I want the statement to end, once I push enter, you can see that our code is not breaking anymore. And to show you that num is working how it's supposed to be working, if I was to type in num, and remember, I'm adding one more to num. So if I push enter, I get 2. So nothing is breaking right here. And the reason why it broke the first time, like I said, After Effects was thinking that this plus sign was a continuation of this statement right here, which it wasn't the case. I would highly recommend that you put a semicolon for each line just to be on the safe side and you don't make mistakes like this. So I'm going to go ahead and put a semicolon for each line, except for this last one. This last one is the last line, and After Effects is going to basically look at it as an expression. And just remember, with statements, when After Effects look at the code, it's always going to read the code from top to bottom. So it's going to go into this first line and look at this var and see that we call it list and we assign it a array of 0. It's going to go to the next line and then see that we had a var called num. We assigned it 1 and so on and so forth. And it's going to go in that order. So anytime that you're making code, just remember After Effects is reading from top to bottom. So where you place your code is important. And one more thing to note about statements, that it doesn't really care about space, except for when you're calling out a keyword like var, if, or whatever. I need a space between var and list, or var or any other type of name or any other keyword next to it. So After Effects will know that this is the keyword var. But if I was to get rid of, let's say I get rid of the space right here, and I added space right here, and if I push enter, nothing is breaking. After Effects is totally okay with my code having no space between the num name equal and one, and this space between this double plus sign and num. And var is not the only type of statement that exists. Of course, there's other statements like if, for, else, while, catch, throw, switch, and many more that I'm not going to name right now, but I will go over at some point in a future tutorial. So next, I want to get into talking about comments. But before we go into our time layer, I just want to explain what a comment is. A comment is a text of code that is ignored by After Effects. And the reason why you probably want to use a comment is to communicate with yourself code that is not easy to understand, or code you might forget after walking away from a project for a very long time. So if I was to walk away from this project and come back in another 2 months, I can read my comments and understand what's going on. And also, you can use comments for code that you are not comfortable with deleting or editing at the time. So let's go into the two comments that you will end up using. One is the single line comment, and the other comment that you use is the multi-line comment. And of course, the single line comment is just going to comment out one line. So if I go in here and type in double forward slash, this whole line right here is commented out. So if I was to push enter in a number pad, and you see we get an error. But if I come over here and read what's going on, first property or method name frame rate and class global is missing or does not exist. So since we commented out frame rate, if frame rate appears anywhere else in my code, After Effects is not going to know what to do with it because it doesn't have a value since we commented out earlier. So if I get rid of this again, the code is back to normal. And with a single line comment, you don't have to comment out a line from the beginning. You can also comment out the middle or the end. So if I comment this part out and type in 24 frames, which is my current frame rate for this composition, my code doesn't change. And if I move before the second or after the second, you can see that it's 23 right here. And once we get to 1 second, once we move up one frame, we get 1 second. And like I said, you can put a single line comment at the end. So if I wanted to, for whatever reason, put this variable is the frame rate of the composition this way, the next time I come back to this code, I understand what's going on. Everything is all right. And I would know, or anybody else would know, anytime I use this frame rate variable, that is basically the expression for our frame rate for this composition. Well, the next comment you can use is the multi-line comment. And it does exactly what it sounds like it does. It comment out multiple lines. So the syntax for that would be forward slash star star forward slash. Anything between these two stars right here is going to be commented out. So if I get rid of that and put star forward slash right here, push enter. Of course, we're getting the same error as we did before. And it says the property or method name FD is missing. So this is between the two stars. And if I use this anywhere else, of course, it's going to tell me that it doesn't exist. One more advantage that the multi-line comment has is that you don't have to use it for multiple lines. If I wanted to, I could just comment out this one and this division sign right here. If I go to the front and type in forward slash star, star forward slash, then this one no longer exists. And only thing that's left in this variable is this FD variable from before for frame duration. So if I push enter, we should get some type of weird number for our timer. If you look over here, you can see that our frame duration is giving us this long number. And that's basically it for comments. I hope that you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did enjoy this tutorial, I have more videos on expressions and more to come in the future. Until the next time, peace out, world.